Maulvis of their time. They were hated by the rulers. Most of them had serious problems with the ruling parties, but still they were the most loved people in Awam. But now, why can't we have such people who are loved by the people in general, the public, and can, you know, fight back? We've got, we were talking about Dr. Israr. He was not even loved by the people. He was not famous enough.
No Maulvi is going to be.
But they were. They had, we've got a different definition of Maulvi at that time.
No, but it's the same thing. Actually, they were way bigger Maulvis, way more classical.
Classical Maulvi. So now we've lowered the definition of Maulvi.
No, we haven't lowered the definition or the perception. What we've done is we've changed the solvent.
Okay. We're going back to science.
Yeah, this is the only science. There is no other science. Yeah. If Shafei was in Russia,
yeah,
with the same brain, same abilities, and even if, let me give you a simpler example. If Shafi'i comes in today, he'll be the most hated guy, just like Israr or Ishaq or anyone else. Why do you think people don't hate Ghamdi as much on the left as they
because Ghamdi, Ghamdi is legitimizing a lot of wrongs.
No, it's not wrong. It's not about wrong or rights. Yeah. If he represents something which is theologically pro
left,
not left, the prevalent
superpower, yeah.
And then, you know, it's not about liberalism or leftism or right.
The same was being done by Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. He was
otherwise the guy was everywhere.
Yeah,
he was all over the place. This guy had no thought. Actually, he was. I think
you choose your words intelligently, because you know when you go after Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan, you might, you know, get a lot of
the disease.
Oh my God, don't say that.
Yeah, you were the disease, and you better understand that. Yeah. I think people like Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan because they haven't read him.
Yeah.
Once you read him, you'll be like, he just didn't declare prophethood, otherwise he believed in everything which was pro-English version of Islam.
So, yeah, but you know, still, you know, he's got a lot of following.
And, I don't think so.
Our texts are full of his... his heroic history
Our texts are full of things that he did for the university, not for anything else.
Yeah, yeah.
So it doesn't really matter what his name was or what he looked like or what he believed in.
Yeah,
he was more of a philanthropist he's famous as a philanthropist, not as a philosopher.
As an educational leader,
two things he believed in.
Yeah.
Other than the three prayers only, you wouldn't know. You know, and I've read about him. My God. This guy was a lunatic.
Really? Don't say that. I don't know. People are going to go after you.
I think anyone with this common sense intact, if you read about and read whatever he actually wrote, you'll find out that he was the epitome of apologentia. You know what I'm saying? He was. I think if it were up to him, he would have changed a lot of
figure.
He would have done some serious
damage.
Damage to Hadith and the Quran as well. If it were up to him, of course, it would not up to him.
So the question itself was telling us that people, why should we hate mullahs? But what about the mullahs of the time of Akbar?
Let me give you know what about Shafi'i and Hanbali. People hated Shafi'i and Hanbali.
Yeah,
but that was like the landscape of the current day Yemen right now, literally, and that's how I see Yemen right now.
Yeah.
Shafi was sentenced to death twice.
Yeah.
Hanifa was sentenced to death and did, you know, end up, the sentence was carried forth.
Carried forward, yeah.
Humbal was sentenced to death.
Yeah.
Twice, to be exact. Imam Malik was the most hated man in Basra.
Yeah.
These people were not